The ZEUS laser is the zettawatt equivalent ultra short pulse laser system. It's a facility which is funded by the National Science Foundation. It will be an ultra short pulse laser system. The unique characteristics of the facility are that it will house the ZEUS laser, which will be operating at 3 petawatts. It will be the highest power laser in the US, and it will be a user facility. So researchers, primarily academic researchers from the US, will come University of Michigan to do experiments, and also it'll be available for researchers from around the world as well. What you would do if you're interested in doing an experiment, you submit a proposal online, and then there's a panel, which University of Michigan doesn't really have anything to do with, and that panel looks at all the proposals and picks the ones which are the best. It'll be used for fundamental research into plasma physics and particle accelerators on a very small scale. And so the applications there could be for things like medicine or for remote sensing or for fundamental studies like just how these huge fields interact with matter or trying to reproduce some of the physics in other parts of the universe in the laboratory scale here on Earth, like some of the physics of a black hole or some of the physics of a gamma ray burst and things like that. There are two types of lasers fundamentally. One is continuous, like your barcode reader at the grocery store, or a pulsed laser, and the ZEUS is a pulsed laser. And the ZEUS, it has an extremely short pulse, and the pulse duration will be about 25 femtoseconds. A femtosecond is 10 to the minus 15 seconds. And so what we're trying to do is take one of these ultra short laser pulses and try to put as much energy as we possibly can in that laser pulse to make a very, very high power. And the duration of the pulse will be extremely short, and we're trying to put as much energy in the pulse as we can.
In one of the target areas, we have our signature colliding beam geometry, where we'll be able to split the laser pulse into two parts, send them to different shiny mirrors which focus the light down, the very high intensities that we need, and that will enable us to have both an electron beam interacting with the laser pulse itself. Our experience with this first experiment will give us confidence and practice so that we can offer future users a smoother experience.